In this video, we're going to be talking about embedded schedules in Revit, but first let's cover what are embedded schedules and when you should use them. When you're creating a new Revit schedule, you have to pick out a category. This means that each schedule will cover only one category of elements in Revit. Now, this is really useful because you usually don't want to go too wide in terms of the categories. However, sometimes you might want to stack those categories up in the schedule. So the example that I'm going to be showing you in this video is, let's say you have a building and there you have some rooms and you actually want to create a schedule, a room schedule, but for each room you want to have an embedded furniture schedule that is going to show all of the furniture for each room. So you want to have a room and then all of the furniture below that, and then the next room and all of the furniture below that, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to be showing you exactly how you can create that by using embedded schedules. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is the office building project. I have a whole course on how to create this building, but for now, let's create a new schedule. So I'll just go here to the View tab, then go to Schedules, and then click on Schedule Quantities. For the first category, we're going to pick out the room category. So let's search for room. Here we have rooms, and then let's click OK. Now we have to figure out our fields. So for the fields, I want to have number. So let's search for number, bring that in, name, and then finally, I want to have level. Now, if you want to rearrange these, you can use these little arrow keys. Actually, I'm perfectly happy with this layout. Okay, so once we have this, I can just click OK and it's going to create that schedule. Now, I actually want to make some changes. So first thing I want to do is I actually want to filter the schedule down so it only shows the rooms on the second level. So let's say I'm only doing the layout for the second level, so let's pick that. So you can just go here to filter and then filter by level equals and then set it to second level. And then click OK. So now we just reduce this to our second level. Then let's go to sorting and grouping. And first I want to sort by number, make sure it's ascending, and then we can add a blank line. And then I want to sort by name. Okay. And then finally, for the itemized every instance, I'm just going to leave that checked on. Click OK. And this is what we have now. Now we have this gap, and that's actually really good because we then want to show below each one all of the furniture, and then we want to have a gap before the next room. Now, one thing that's perhaps a bit too much here is the actual level field, just because everything is second level, so it doesn't really make sense. I can just name this room schedule level 2. I don't have to show second level for each one of the rows. So for that, we can go here to formatting, click on level, and then just hide that field by clicking on hidden field. And that's pretty much everything that we want. And we finally have our room schedule completed. And now we can embed our furniture schedule. So for that, go here to embedded schedules. You want to check on embedded schedule, and then you want to search for the category, which in this case is going to be furniture. Select furniture and then click before we click OK, we want to go to embedded schedule properties. And here basically we have the same fields as we have for our main schedule. And I'm just going to search for, let's say here, I want to have my family. I want to have an image for each one. And then also it makes sense to include count. So let's include that as well. And then here for the filtering, let's sort that by family, just like this. And then I'm just going to uncheck itemize every instance because we already have a count parameter, so it doesn't make sense to show each one. It's just going to give us the count. And then let's click OK again. And now the schedule is going to look like this. Now that you look at the schedule, it makes sense to have like a total count for the office furniture. So let's go back to embedded schedules, back to embedded properties or embedded schedule properties, and here in sorting and grouping, let's do grand totals and click OK again, and now we have that. Okay, so once we have completed our schedule, or at least this phase, now it's time to see what would this actually look like on a sheet. So let's open up a sheet. So here I'm just going to open up one of these sheets, just like that. I have a blank sheet, and then let's find our room schedule too, and just drag it over and place it on that sheet, and it's going to look like this. Now I'm just going to select it and extend the name just a little bit. So for these longer names, we want to actually see the end. Okay, perfect. And perhaps this extend the image and name a little bit, and then the count can stay like that. Okay, so now it's time to actually, let's do it like this. Okay, now it's time to load in the images. So as you can see here, we have the image field for our furniture, and we don't have any images. So for images, what you need to do is, well, first you need to create them. So let's actually tile these views. So I'm just going to undock the sheet and then tile it here on this side, just like this. Okay, so now let's go here to the chair, select that, go to highlight and model, and it's just going to bring this up. Okay, I'm just going to click close. So that's basically the chair. So what can I do now with this chair is go into edit family, and it's going to open up that chair family. Here I can set this to textures or realistic even. Yeah, I prefer textures. Okay, so you can set that view like this, and then you can just export the image. So you can just go here to file, export, go down, find images and animation, go to image, and now we can just export that. So I'm just going to save this on my desktop. I'm going to zoom to 50%, and then I'm just going to set this to, yeah, we can go with medium, 300 pixels per inch for the image raster quality. And now just click OK. So it's going to export that, and I can just close this, and I'm not going to save any changes. Okay, so having done that, we can go back here to the schedule. We can go to that chair desk, click here on this little builder button to load in the image, and then these are all of the images that we have in our project. So currently we don't have any furniture images, but if I go here to add, I can just search for images now, and here I have that M chair desk, and click open, and it's going to load that image in. And now I can just click OK, and it's just going to bring that image and place it here on the schedule. So I'm basically going to repeat this entire process for each of the images. I've already exported them, so I just need to now place them. But you do this for each piece of the furniture, and then also make sure to just save those images so you can use them on later projects. And with a little settings, this is what we get. I've just changed the name, so this is the second level furniture. Okay, and finally, I just want to make some adjustments to the rooms. So here you can see we have this stair, we have the lobby, and we also have the restroom. They don't really have any furniture, and it's just standing there, confuseless in this schedule. So I'll get rid of those by using a filter. So let's go here to filter, edit, and then I'm just going to filter this by number and say I want everything that's greater than, and then the room number 2-01, and also I want the number everything that's less than, and then 2-09. So basically that's going to get rid of these two because they're smaller, or they're less than 2-01. And then this one will get rid of the restroom because that's greater than 2-09. So when I click OK, it's just going to get rid of those. And here on the sheet, we can see that schedule. So let me actually just close this, so we can see the schedule on the sheet. Looks really nice. And finally, what I'll do is I'll just going to break this by clicking on this button here, and then we can just make this schedule smaller. And I actually like to break it by room, so either like this, or kind of make sure to complete the room. So perhaps it would looks something like this. Let's extend it a little bit. Yeah, so now everything seems to be in line. So this is the secretary room, and there is this desk, and then we have the office one, and it has this furniture, and we have the grand totals, and so on and so forth. So I think this is a really nice kind of visual schedule representing each of the rooms and all of the furniture inside of the rooms. Now, if you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find all of those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.